Savers Vloggers, welcome back to my channel, Culinary Vlogs by Z. Today's recipe is inspired by Chinese cuisine and is made with egg noodles and stir-fried veggies. But I'm going to be adding a spicy twist to this to suit my South African Indian palate and to make it of restaurant quality for my family to enjoy. If you are new to my channel, welcome. My name is Zakia. Please consider subscribing to my channel so you don't miss out on amazing content. So, without wasting any time, let's get started on our chicken chow mein. The preferred protein for this dish is chicken, but you can add in beef or tofu if you like. So I'm using a wok, and in this wok I've placed in 3 tablespoons of butter ghee. And if you need the recipe of butter ghee, then I'm putting up the link above and you can get the recipe from that link. Those of you that do follow my vlogs, you will notice that this is the ghee that we made, I think it was this week sometime. So yeah, this is butter ghee. Once the butter ghee has melted, I'm going to add in 1 onion sliced and wait for this to brown. In a separate pot, I've added in 1 liter of water and I'm going to add in 2 bricks of egg noodles. So that's 1 and that's 2. And this we're going to bring to a boil until the egg noodles are soft and ready to be put into the wok. So I haven't added anything into this pot, I'm just going to boil the egg noodles as it is. Once our onions have slightly browned, I'm going to add in the chicken. And I'm using 500 grams of chicken fillet that I've actually thinly cut into small pieces. So smaller pieces are perfect for stir fries. You don't want it to be too lumpy and too big. Then just give the chicken a quick toss. And you're going to make sure that this is on high. And remember, this is on the highest setting on your stove. To this chicken, I'm going to add in 1 teaspoon of rough salt and 1 tablespoon of chili garlic, red chili garlic paste. And then just mix that again. So we're going to cook this chicken until it is completely dried out and no water remains at the bottom or at the base of this wok. So this dish can actually be ready in 15 minutes, provided you have the egg noodles boiled and kept aside. And yeah, that's quick and easy dinner for a weekday night. Now that our chicken has cooked, and I can see only butter ghee remaining at the bottom, I'm going to add in a stir-fry mix, and this was a pre-packed stir-fry mix. So you can see it has cabbage, carrots, peppers, it's also got some baby marrow. So just add that entire 500 gram pack in. And then toss everything again. Now remember, this will come with some more water, so you will find that there will be water appearing at the bottom of the pot. And we're going to mix this nicely. Chinese cuisine at its best. Give this about 5 minutes in the pot. And I've also got some mushrooms that I'm going to add in. But we're going to add the mushrooms in last because that actually cooks quicker and we don't want to have mushy mushrooms at the end of our log. So this as it is, you can serve as a chicken and veg stir fry, which is also quite healthy. You can substitute the butter ghee for olive oil if you want a healthier option, or coconut oil. And this would be a meal that's already ready, and we just add in the sauces for some added taste and flavor. So at this stage, I noticed that there is no water at the bottom. So I'm going to throw in my mushrooms and allow this to soften. Once you hear that the bottom actually, there's no sizzle and there's no butter, no water, you're going to switch this off. But make sure that before you switch it off, your mushrooms are actually soft and your baby marrow is also soft. Once you're certain that all the vegetables are cooked properly, you're going to switch the stove off. Once you've switched off your stove, you're going to add in a little of the egg noodles in at a time, so about a spoonful at a time, and then just toss it around. So this will ensure that you have egg noodles throughout the dish and not just in the center. I've just changed my spoon to a spaghetti spoon so that I can mix everything well. Now comes the easiest part, to add in all the flavors. And for this, I'm adding in 3 tablespoons of soy sauce. Then I'm adding in 3 tablespoons of sweet chili sauce. And lastly, I've got some sriracha sauce. And then just toss all of this again, making sure that it's mixed nicely and the flavors are throughout the dish. To garnish this, I'm adding in some spring onion. So this is about a few sprigs of spring onion. And I'm also adding in some roasted cashews as a garnish. Hope you enjoyed making this dish with me and will use it as a quick and easy meal option. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you in the next vlog.